As I look back over their life, I remember when they were seeing each other, and I was in Richmond, and they wanted to talk to me when I got back from Richmond. They wanted to get married. We've been through the stuff. We've been through it. But you know what? I said yes. Jim, you can have her as long as you take good care of her. And I can say today, he's been a good husband, a good dad. And I don't say today that he's my son-in-law, but he's my son.
Twenty-five years ago, I pledged my love commitment to you, but it seems like only yesterday. I promised to love you, honor, and comfort, and keep you. I pledged to be by your side in sickness and in health, in times of want and times of plenty, for better, for worse, for the rest of our lives. We have had all of those things, and you have been by my side as we created a family and a home and a life together. Today, at the beginning of 26 years as a husband and wife, pledge my eternal love for you and eagerly awaiting life to bring us. I love you and look forward to the next 25. But guess what? We made it and we got a
wandering house. Being married to you has exceeded any expectations that I had. I really wasn't sure what life would be like. I couldn't think that far ahead to 25 years later, but you've done more for me in this 25 years than anybody has done total for me in my life. Wherever we are in another 25 years, I will never forget the love that you've shown me and the beauty that you see in me that I don't see in myself. And that I thank you for. And I thank you for teaching me how to love myself and staying with me when I questioned you about your love for me. And you stuck with me. And you've been an amazing provider, amazing friend, amazing husband, and an amazing father. And I love you more than anything. I hope you will always know how much and deep I love you.